Hello and welcome to the BDMS Wellness Clinic. I'm Dieter Burkhardt and it is my privilege to bring to you a special clip we're calling Ask the Experts. Today we're joined with Dr. Tanupon Virunhakkarun, Chief Operating Officer of the BDMS Wellness Clinic. We're also joined by Professor Jiří Dvořák, Professor of Neurology at the University of Zurich, Senior Consultant at the Schultes Clinic, former Chief Medical Officer of FIFA for the past 23 years, and Medical Consultant here at the BDMS Wellness Clinic. Today we have a special segment where we've asked our readers on Facebook to give us a question that they'd like to ask the experts. And the topic for today is heart rate. So Dr. Tanupon, what is the importance of looking at heart rate?
When you're asking me about the heart rate, we have to know the heart rate is the cardiovascular system. So I'm talking about the people who are concerned that their heart rate is higher than normal. It means their cardiovascular disease, their heart pumping, working harder. So my experience is obesity have very, very high negative impact on cardiovascular disease. So it means when you're concerned about your heart rate, you back to see yourself, what is the percent of the body fat in your bodies? The guidelines said the men should have the body fat not higher than 28, and the women should have the body fat lower than 32. When you cut down your body fat, you're losing your weight. Make sure that this is the fat, not the muscle. So this is the things that can help your heart rate to improve more.
Well, thank you very much, Dr. Tanupon. And the question we had today from Facebook is it important to monitor heart rate during exercise?
Well, generally, my profession is neurologist and spite expert. But with my involvement with FIFA, I have been forced to get deeper into the subject of cardiovascular system due to the occurrence of the unfortunate events of sudden cardiac arrest in young athletes. And it's worldwide. So we have to be prepared. And during the course, we have been actually making mandatory to have a regular assessment of the heart function with electrocardiograms, with ultrasound and other measures, just with the way to mitigate the risk factors. So from all this experience, I'm actually supporting the monitoring of heart rate, even for us, for all of the normal population. And I wear also this wearable, which monitor the heart rate throughout the day, throughout the different activities. When we are resting, we are expecting to have the heart rate between 60 to 80. If we are well-trained athletes, even recreational, the heart rate would go a little bit lower. But during the day, we should have several bouts of 10 minutes where we get with the heart rate 200, 120. So also the heart exercise. So this is good to monitor in different activities, even during the sleep. When the heart rate goes down, this is physiological. That should be like this. And if we feel some unpleasant feeling, shortest of breath when we walk up the stairs, which is unusual, when we have a pressure in the chest or even a very unspecific feeling in the shoulder or in the left arm, then it's the time to consult the physician.
So if we're all looking at our devices and we're seeing what our heart rates are while we're exercising, are there any general guidelines that we have where we should say, okay, if it goes over a certain number or if I'm resting under a certain number, that would indicate a concern?
First of all, if you are unfit or if our viewers are unfit, then start to exercise slowly. Don't go just right away and start to get your heart rate 240, 150. That's definitely not a good idea. So you start gradually to increase, but it's good to have those bouts during the exercise. Either you are running or you are playing football. We have found that team sports, like playing football, is almost the ideal regular exercise because you have short runs, you have fast runs, and you have also endurance. It's also advisable for the viewers to get a individual recommendation for the particular person. But when you decide that you want to change the way of life, that you decide to have a regular physical exercise, get the appropriate advice.
I agree with Professor. I love the word, start slow, go slow. for the beginner people or any people who want to start exercise, you cannot start real hard. Mm. It's going to make a lot of negative impact on your bodies. And I want to add more about the risk factor when you have the high heart rate and you have to concern. They have a lot of things that, for example, like lack of sleep. When you lack of sleep, your heart rate in the next day is going up higher. When you're smoking, yes, your cardiovascular or the vessel wall is not good. They make the heart rate is higher. And the other one thing very important is the stress. Now we can measure the stress, or we call the cortisol or the hormone of stress hormone. When you have high stress, you're sitting in the car, the traffic is not good, you have rush meeting all day, you have the busy lifestyle, everything is related to your heart.
Thank you, Dr. Tanapan. Thank you, Professor Jiří, for sharing your insights and your expertise with us today. And thank you all very much for joining us. We hope to see you for our next round of Ask the Experts.